Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, the Cain Velasquez, voice on the crack there a little bit. The Cain Velasquez debut from last night on SmackDown is uploading right now on the channel. And also, I'll be watching The Joker tonight, so I'll give you guys my review for that, probably be up tomorrow morning. But let's get into the controversial. There's a lot of people really bashing my man The Rock, saying, oh my god, this is so watered down. Yes, it's not The Rock from the 90s. Yes, it's not Hollywood Rock that was last night. It was good to see The Rock. They said it was like 3 years since we saw The Rock. So it was good to see The Rock. Now, there was some people that were really pissed. Now, you go ahead and you advertise The Undertaker. You advertised Hulk Hogan. You advertised Kurt Angle. You advertised Stone Cold Steve Austin. You got things. I think they showed a Kurt Angle. They showed Hogan's back. They showed Kurt Angle and they showed Hogan's back. But you advertised Stone Cold and The Undertaker. And we don't get that. Now, I understand probably why. Because at that point when they advertised, oh, Stone Cold, Hogan, Angle, all those other people that were advertised. Lita, Trish Stratus were advertised. We got that before The Rock even agreed to be on SmackDown. I think The Rock agreed to be on SmackDown last week on Tuesday. No, it was this week on Tuesday. Was it not like this week on Tuesday? No, it was Monday. My bad, guys. It was Monday. The Rock like officially said, oh, I'll be on SmackDown on Monday. You know what I'm saying? So at that point, I bet you Vince McMahon's like, oh, okay, Hogan, Undertaker, Austin, hold on, guys. I got The Rock coming in. You guys, you've done enough. You've been on the show like the last couple, at least three times the last 2 months. He's like, stay home. I got The Rock. So I think that's what probably happened. Vince McMahon's like, okay, I got The Rock. You guys can stay home. You don't need to come. I got The Rock. The Rock is big enough name on his own. I don't need you guys to come. That's probably what happened. But I hate when Vince does that. Don't advertise some people and they don't show up. Imagine if you paid, and they were in L.A. last night. That's like how much money, about what, at least $3,000 or $4,000 for those front row seats, and you don't see Stone Cold or The Undertaker, even though they get to see The Rock, but that's still, I hate when they do false advertisement. Like, stick to the script, or don't advertise them at all. So let's get to the reaction for The Rock. I mean, again, some people didn't like The Rock last night. It was like watered down to them. I mean, listen here, it's The Rock. The Rock's always going to be funny. Let's check out it for you guys.
I mean, Becky, everyone here knows who should be starting this show off, and it's the King. Do you really think you're still the man?
Take one more step and we'll find out.
Take one more step and we'll find out. The smell! Like, look at that, people. Look at the reaction already, people. It's The Rock. Yeah, I wanted to get copyright strike for The Rock's entrance, but, I mean, it was good. Look, the stage was fucking amazing. I love that. Whoever's going to be able to make that on W2K20, make that immediately. That shit looks amazing. But look at that, people. You can look at the reaction. It's The Rock. Huh? There we go. But nobody can control the crowd like The Rock, man. The Rock is still the best ever to do it in the ring on the microphone. Ever. Ever. So, that's still on my bucket list, is to still see The Rock. That's on my bucket list, still to see The Rock.
This isn't your home anymore. You're no longer the great one. As a matter of fact, you're looking at the great one. You're looking at the most...
But Baron Corbin's got better on the microphone.
King in sports entertainment.
Yeah, my man Baron Corbin's got better on the microphone. He's really improving, though, man.
Thank you so much. Just because you won King of the Ring, it doesn't actually make you a king. And it certainly sure as hell doesn't make you want to walk around here dressing like a 35-year-old virgin hanging out at Comic-Con.
Oh, man, they cut out the line of The Rock calling him a broke-ass Burger King on crack.
You gotta get it in your head. See, Becky Lynch
is the man. You'll see Becky walking around here.
However, you don't see Becky Lynch walking around here holding a pair of testicles, do you?
There'd be a whole lot bigger than yours.
Yo, but that damn Burger King on crack was still funny as shit, though, man.
My testicles are perfectly adequate. And I'm the king, so I'll dress however I want. I'll do whatever I want because I'm superior to
you. I'm superior to you.
I am superior to all of you. And the way I see it is this city only has one king, and it sure as hell is not LeBron James.
Gotta bring my man LeBron in there, huh, Baron Corbin?
Is that what you think?
It doesn't matter what you think.
It doesn't matter what you think!
Becky!
You're legit. You want Money in the Bank. You want King of the Ring. You retired Kurt Angle. Look, you're a badass.
Are you trying to say he's a super
tough dude?
Because you're a super tough dude. In 3 seconds, these people are going to be chanting something that they think every time they see you.
S-T-D. The Rock got over STD on national TV, people.
That's what happens when you come out and you insult the jabroni
people. Beating, pie-eating, trail-blazing, eyebrow-raising.
From Los Angeles all the way to Japan, you're getting ready to get your monkey ass whooped by The Rock.
And the Man.
There's no way to treat royalty. Get out of there, King.
Baron Corbin like, all right, let's go.
Look at this. What a valiant warrior. Oh, no. Becky going right after Corbin. That's Becky and The Rock working in tandem.
Boom. Oh. Leg drop by Becky.
With her patented leg drop.
Look at the crowd, people. I still have to see The Rock live, though. The Rock and Undertaker are the only people I've missed. That's it, man. I've seen everybody else I wanted to see. Boom! Boom! Rock bottom! It's The Rock, man.
I love you, SmackDown.
It's just a smile. Rock is cooking. It's The Rock, people. Now, again, say what you want to say, but the one thing is, I agree with people. It is kind of sad. You're looking out there and the freaking superstars have now. Nobody on that roster even comes close. You can say John Cena if you want to, but nobody even comes close on the active roster to The Rock. It's just like, WWE does admit it. With them bringing Cain Velasquez, Ronda Rousey, Brock Lesnar back, it's them admitting to themselves, we can't make superstars no more. And that's kind of sad, though, man. But it was great seeing The Rock. You guys comment down below what you think of The Rock's promo. As far as Hell in a Cell preview predictions, they added one more match. They've added Charlotte Flair versus Bayley for the SmackDown Women's title. So there's four matches now on Hell in a Cell. So, damn, Hell in a Cell is tomorrow. We only have four matches. You know what, for the hell of it, let me give you my predictions right now. Charlotte Flair beats Bayley. Sasha beats Becky. Eric Rowan and Luke Harper beat Daniel Bryan and Roman Reigns. Daniel Bryan probably turns on Roman Reigns. As far as the main event, again, at house shows they've been running where, like, Seth Rollins hits Bray Wyatt with, like, three curve stomps, and, like, the lights go out and Bray Wyatt just disappears, and that's it. Would the hell would they do that on Hell in a Cell and have that happen? That would be crazy. I don't know, guys. That's only match that's, like, really having me hard to predict, but I mean, they've been doing that at house shows where Seth Rollins hits three curb stomps and Bray Wyatt just disappears and that's it. Would you end Hell in a Cell that way? That would be such bullshit to do that. So, you know what? For the heck of it, Bray Wyatt wins. If he loses, we'll see what happens on the internet because you just can't have him lose. Like, he's the hottest act in your company. You can't have him lose. So, I'm going with Bray Wyatt, even though I have this gut feeling that Seth Rollins is going to win. That's my predictions, guys. Again, there's only four matches, so that's my prediction. So I'll catch you guys back here tomorrow morning for the Joker review, and then you'll get the Hell in a Cell review Monday morning. So catch you guys tomorrow morning for the Joker review.